my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Anticipate Monica and all of her family joining the Greater Fowler Girls family. And today is all about Monica and Wayne and their love and how God brought them together. And you've got quite a heritage, because Wayne's grandparents were married 66 years. Barb and Wayne celebrated their 50th last year. My husband and I celebrated our 50th this year. Dee and Kit are at 36. Terry and your husband are
38.
So you're about 30. So you can go 50, 60 years.
You're here.
Pressure. The only way that's not happening is that you're not alive. So.
Are you going to tell them
just
you're
80?
Right.
That's it. You'll just be 80 at your 50th anniversary. But I'm thrilled to have all of you here. I mean, we're just so excited that our nephew Wayne has found such a beautiful girl. And we read your face posts, and we know how much you love your man. So I just thought it'd be good to, even though we have name tags, we're just going to say your name and how you know Monica or how you know Wayne. So we'll start with Amy.
Looks like she's been in the sun.
Yeah, last week when we were in San Diego for a car show. I'm Amy, and I'm Monica's cousin, and her other cousin couldn't be here today because she was not feeling well.
Oh, great.
I'm Monica's mom. My name is Terry, and Monica is truly the best daughter. She's very honest and lovely girl.
And
Misty.
And Terry is on her way in a couple of days to
Monica's sister. Her older sister Vanessa is having a baby, so I'll be going to Okinawa, Japan, in 2 days. Wish me luck. It's a 17-hour in the air and in layover. So think of me on Monday. Just. White
Duckling. You're stretching out.
Her due date is on the 13th, so I'm going there for the birth.
You might think so. Janet.
I'm Janet Petrowich, and I am the oldest sister of the Petrowich clan. This is my sister, youngest sister. Unfortunately, she'll always be younger than me. So I'm her first aunt. And Amy is my daughter-in-law. She's with my son. So we've got a deep family connection. They've been together for many, many,
21 years in November.
Oh, wow.
And I've been together with my man for 35 years already.
Oh, wow.
And he's going to retire soon.
Nice. And our bride, Monica.
Okay, I'm Dee. I'm Wayne's mom, and we are so thrilled. I mean, when Wayne said, "Do you want to love her?" I said, "No, well, we love her."
Right now, you're making Misty too.
I love her, both of them, because I think they're both just exceptional people, and we'll have a good match. I think it's a great match.
That's great.
I'm Pam. I'm Dee's cousin. Well, actually, her husband's cousin, I guess, but I took on her. So I hope you guys have as good a relationship with all of your family combining.
I'm Joyce, and we've known Wayne since, second grade?
Yeah, soccer.
Soccer, and he and my oldest were Eagle Scouts together, and I have to admit that when you guys were in Hawaii, we were taking my husband and I were taking bets on if you were going to be getting me engaged. I won.
That's awesome.
I'm Kathy Roney, and I'm Wayne's other mother. we met Kitten D and Wayne on the soccer field probably about the same time period, I would think, or maybe a year after. Became fast friends. My son Brendan and Wayne became best buddies and went through school together and joined the Marine Corps together. Went separate paths during the Marine Corps, but still remained best friends. Unfortunately, my son was supposed to be a groomsman, but decided to re-enlist in the Army and is in basic training right now, so he's not going to be able to be here for the wedding. He's devastated, but we're so happy to have Monica in the family and eventually at the table for some biscuits and gravy.
Hi, I'm Michelle. I'm one of the bridesmaids, and I'm at Monica. I don't want to say university, like I'm British. I mean, my college. And oh man, she's just an awesome woman out of my life. She makes me a better woman, a stronger lady, and just proud to follow my dreams and be my own.
We met at college. And oh man, she's just an awesome woman to have in my life. She makes me a better woman, a stronger lady, and just proud to follow my dreams and be who I am. And so I'm just really honored to stand up with her, and I just want to wish her all the happiness in the entire world.
Hi everybody, I'm Annie. I'm a bridesmaid, and I met Monica at grad school in Sacramento. And we've been really good friends ever since, and she inspires me, and she's a great person. So I'm really honored to be your bridesmaid.
Hello, I'm Stephanie Kasperson, and my husband and I owned a brewery for a short time, that Spec Hops Brewing Company, and we had the pleasure of meeting you two there. And didn't get a lot of free time when we had the business, but now that the business is closed, we've actually had a chance to go out and do a lot of fun stuff together. So when you guys got engaged, I was so excited for you, and I know you guys are going to be a great couple, and just can't wait until the day and get to cheers you.
I'm Lucia. I'm Wayne's cousin, and I met Monica. We talked about it. I guess it was last Easter that when she came over. That's where I met. And Wayne was in our wedding, the little ring bear.
That's okay.
He was 7, did you think? 7? 8?
I don't know.
Somewhere around there. Yeah. So yeah. And I've known Wayne since he was 4. Got all those pictures. I remember.
Well, I'm the grandma. Petrovich. I have 4 daughters. That's 1. That's 2. 1 is living in Kentucky. And where's the other one living?
Las Vegas. Kathy's
Vegas. Vegas, right. And they're all great girls. And they have great children. And can't wait till I see pictures of my newest baby.
I'll be sending lots of pictures, don't worry. Also, my grandma gives the best comments on Facebook.
Yes.
And she doesn't do spell check ever.
It's called creative
spelling. Yes. Best comments on Facebook.
Well, all that stuff came kind of late for me. Because I'm going to be 90 years old in January.
And you do Facebook.
Yeah, that's amazing.
But I know about 5 different things that I can do, and I need a teacher to teach me the rest of them.
I'm Sherry Bradley, and I am Kyle's mom. He's the best care. And we have known Wayne since, was it 7th grade? I think it was 7th grade.
Yeah, junior high.
Scouting, and the first experience we had with the Wilson family was Kyle really wanted to attend this one activity, and we weren't going to be home for the weekend. I said, you're just not going to be able to go. And he goes, no, if I find a ride, can I go? He goes, I have a friend at school, Wayne. I go, but I don't know Wayne. I don't know Wayne's parents. So we met, and we sat down with the Wilsons and had a chat. And we said, you know, it's okay. You can go with them. So Dee calls up and says, but why doesn't he just spend the weekend with us? And so Kyle went over and spent the whole weekend with the Wilsons. Went to the activity on Saturday, and Saturday night, Dee is driving him to the hospital. We're out of state, and she's taking Kyle, who she doesn't hardly know, in because he was having a croup attack. Who has a croup attack when they're in seventh grade? But he did. And such a blessing to be brought into our lives, the Wilson family. And we've been being good friends ever since.
I'm Miranda. I'm a bridesmaid. I'm also the best man's
wife.
The best man's wife. Sorry.
It's hot.
But ever since knowing Wayne, and ever since knowing Monica, I'm so happy for both of you. So happy that Wayne found you. And it makes me emotional.
I'm getting misty. Oh,
it was, you knew each other. You went to high school.
Yeah, so I have a funny story about people kept asking, oh, you guys went to high school together? Do you guys know each other? And it's kind of an embarrassing story. Embarrassing for me, but it makes Wayne look like a hero always. So in high school, we weren't really friends. Like I was a real nerd. I hung out, I was like either in the computer lab or the library. I didn't really think Wayne was like really, all my memories of Wayne in high school, he was really popular. I have really magical memories because he was in ROTC raising the flag every morning. And I was like, oh, that guy's so popular. He's like the lead in all the plays. Like he was a cool guy. So those are my magical memories of Wayne in high school. And so I asked him recently, I was like, oh, well, do you remember me at all from high school? And he's like, well, one memory does stand out of like one interaction that we had. So he was like doing something with the rifle, like spinning it or, like practicing like out in the parking lot. And I was walking by and I am not a mean girl. I'm funny in like a snarky, like just funny way, but he's like spinning this rifle and he like drops it or, and I was walking past him. I said, oh, catch much? I was like, that's your memory of me? I was like, sunrise every morning, raising the flag, and me being like, I was like, I'm not a mean girl. I'm surprised you ever called me back. But I meant it in a funny, jokey way.
Yeah.
Lighthearted.
Not did you actually graduate the same year then?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
I didn't know you knew
from high school.
I know. Wow. But, he was super popular. He always says that I was not popular, but he was cool.
So how'd you run back into each other?
So when I moved back from Sacramento, I posted something like, oh, I got a job in San Diego, can't wait. And then Wayne, he's all sneaky. He sent me a message on Facebook. He's like, so, I live in San Diego too, if you want to go out to dinner sometime,
That's nice.
Thank you.
Very sweet.
That's the importance of social media in your
life.
Yeah,
and then I was like, wait a second. I was like, how do I know? Like, and I was like, we went to high school together? Who is this?
Well, between the social media and all the dating things, Providence happens.
Yeah. Yeah, my daughter, Vanessa, met her husband now, who's a major in the Marines, through one of the dating apps.
Oh.
So,
That was a
social media too, because he made his account, and Vanessa, my sister, was his first match. So he only went on one date.
Oh, wow. Wait till you see their baby.
That's what we're going to wait for me.
An angel. The two of them have the same face. When you look at them, you could meld them together and make an angel. That's all you
can And the baby is over at, is a girl, and it's named Cora.
Oh.
And we were talking, and
that's pretty.
That's a name from your side of the
family. Yes, it is. It's our grandmother's name, so it would be Wayne's great-grandmother's name.
Yeah, so that's interesting too.
It is, because you don't hear of Cora very often.
No.
That's really special.
I have to say, because I know I'm always going to open this stuff later, but years ago, we go to the Scottish Games a lot, and I bought a sixpence from, in the Victorian times, they used to put it in their left shoe when they walked down the aisle. So I've kept it for years, just in case, you know, Wayne met that special someone. And so today was the first day I opened it to unwrap it and give it to Monica, and it said, from San Marcos.
Oh, really?
Oh, wow.
Oh, sweet.
Like, that's where they live.
Yeah.
That's
sweet.
That's horrible. Is it San Marcos in Scotland?
No, no, in California.
Oh,
I mean, it's an import company, but they
run
out of San Marcos.
Oh.
I just thought,
that's wild.
iPhone 1. Amy is.
That makes
for a long
sense.
Time, not at all.
Yeah.
Okay.
That makes sense.
So, undergrad. So I got my undergrad in history, and I got my master's degree in public history, and then this is my prom from, because I was working at Frostbites at the time, and I remember, I don't know how to do makeup, and so she did my makeup for me, so it was the first time I ever wore like a full face of makeup. So it's an accomplishment, not wearing makeup until you're 17.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Much more than I ever knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself.